Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We'd like to welcome to the Inner City Athletic Association and SPNN presents the 25th annual alumni basketball game between St. Paul Central and St. Paul Mechanic Art School. I'm Bernard Foster, and to my media left is my colleague in crime, Tim E. Simmons.
Hello.
How you doing, Timmy?
I'm doing very well, Bernard. How are you?
I can't complain. Hey.
Yeah.
It's all tied up, 12-12, okay? So, who do you got this year?
I got who I always have, Central. Who I always have.
Spoke like a true alumni.
Central. I got to have Central in this game. You know, 25 years. Man. Hey, let's do this. That's all I got to say. Fasten your seatbelts, because it's going to be a barn burner. Let's do this.
All right. I'm picking Central, too, only because I believe red-black. But Mechanic Arts, they're loaded this year. They got some young guys out there. I'm like, where'd they get these guys from?
I don't think
they were born when this thing started.
Hey, as they say, I do bleed my red and black, okay? But Mechanic Arts, it's looking tough to me, all right? And the only factor that I give Mechanic Arts is the coach.
All right, I'll give them that point. They have a more distinguished coach on the Mechanic Arts side. I'll give them that edge, but they got some horses over there in Central.
You know, even though I'm looking at Mechanic Arts bench, I'm looking at Central. Central's not depth like they was over the past few years. And you know, matter of fact, they tried to get me out of this seat here, and I told them, no, I get more clock, and ain't nobody coming in to sub me. So I'm staying up here.
Well,
but if I happen to leave for about 5 good minutes, check me out.
I'll see you out there on the floor. Another point. I see they got Preston Cunningham. He's playing this year.
Yeah.
He was a big star back in 1990, I believe. He graduated back then. He's a pretty good player. So they got the bulk in the post for their team if they get in trouble, if they have to go inside. But other than that, it's going to be a good game. It's going to be a lot of, you know, it's who runs out of gas first. That's how I'm looking at it.
Well, I'm looking at it, and the X factor could be Bivens. Second guy from the left. He could be the X factor for Mechanic Arts. You know, because just remember, Mechanic Arts gets everybody from Highland, Harding, and all that. And Central is just Central.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, so that's the benefactor that they get.
Yeah, but they have the youth on their side. But one thing about Bivens, he's one hell of a ball player, but he likes to shoot that three, though. He might get out there and get a little happy shooting the three. They need him inside. He might bite him in the backside. But, we will see.
I also said if the wind blows, he might fall over. I'm just kidding.
But they have other three-point shooters on the team. Jimmy Duran, you know, he's going to be a threat out there shooting that three.
But still running like a youngster.
Oh, yeah.
I look at Emory, man, and Emory's just a classic guy who just loves the game. You know, and is in the best shape.
All right. So, we're about ready to start the introductions here, so.
Let's do it. As they say, let's get ready to rumble. Ding. Round 25.
All right.
Thanks.
Now we want to welcome and thank the alumni committee for putting this together this afternoon. We want to thank the founder, Henry Combs, Eugene Behringer, Leslie Walker. Yeah, well, yours truly, Bernard Walker. Sarah Gustafson, Pam Kelly, Sharon Garrett, Deborah Brown, Vernon Landon, and Dwayne Billups. Let's get this party started.
For a wonderful job you did of putting on this event. 25 years.
It's been a while.
Man, that's beautiful. That's something for the community, man. Man, bless you all, Bernard, Henry, and the rest of you.
Well, I've been with Henry like the last 20 years. Yeah, buddy. But it takes a village.
Yes, it does. Yes, it does. That cameraman over there, too. These cameramen are sharp. Yeah, man, I appreciate y'all giving me all the love.
All right, we're ready to get the introductions here. right, ladies and gentlemen. That was the introductions for our squads today. Let's hope for a great injury-free game. Now let's see who the starting five is up for the Mechanics.
Oh, small starting five.
We got Emory Duran, Eno Griffin, Darren Chapman,
Dwayne Johnson,
and Alan Hicks. And for Centro, Earl Bronaugh, Ronnie Smith, Keel Walker, Preston Cunningham,
Gerald McNeil. This should be interesting. Right now, I don't know who to give the hell. Emory Duran. Preston Cunningham.
I'm going to go with the 12th man. the crowd. And Central controls the tip.
Oh!
Ryan Smith misses an easy layup.
Hicks.
Hicks comes up short.
Emory will be all over the court.
Duran with the hustle. Picks up the Aaron rebound.
There you go.
Outlet pass to McNeil. He takes it all the way in. And Avis.
Nice try, though. Nice try. I like that aggression by Central. Now let's make some shots. They're yelling Hicks to shoot it.
Well, they're giving him that shot.
Come out to it, Ronnie.
Chapman.
Another miss. But they're getting the rebounds.
Central's in a 2-3 zone, which is a good. Force him to make shots.
Off the glass.
No basket if he didn't call it.
Griffin with the kiss off the glass. Here we have points in the game.
You got to call them shots. Take advantage of that, Preston. Take him.
Walker to Smith.
Coach Keel.
Long three and he misses.
But you know what? I'm like a Central's bench right now, too.
And Duran, the big three.
Emory plays 8 days a week. And I don't know how that's possible. 8 days a week? There we go.
Cunningham with the easy two-step to the basket.
Nina's bringing the ball up. Oh, that looked like a double. Johnson pulls.
Yeah.
And hits the three.
D. Johnson with the big three. 6-point advantage for Mechanic Arts, 8-2. But still early in the contest.
Oh, Darren Chapman with a no-look pass. Or should I say a no-look turnover? There they go.
They
right
got
there.
Numbers, but and it's intercepted by Duran. Johnson with the easy two.
Timeout.
And we got our first timeout of the game at 22 minutes and 20 seconds left in the first half. With Mechanic Arts with the commanding 8-point lead at this point.
Come on, Central. Y'all got to get it together, man.
All right, now this the turnovers are playing a part now.
Not again.
Well, Central's already committed three. Mechanic Arts has two.
Now, what Coach Keel is going to do for adjustments. One adjustment is he subbed himself out.
That might work. Chenga Birch checks in.
There it is. As we call him, Speedy Gonzalez.
Well, they got the speed out there. They got Birch and McNeil.
Yes. Chenga could be an X factor, though.
Oh, right, right.
Him and Emory, but he can get past Emory.
Well, Emory's going to need some help.
Emory's a smart defensive player, though. He's a smart player.
Birch Out to McNeil.
That's a mismatch.
Cunningham with a nice little scoop under the basket.
If he doesn't get tired, that could be an X factor there, too.
12-4 game. Here we go on the scoreboard. Durant looking for some of the passes to Johnson. Picks it up to Griffin in the paint, and he loses it. Burch said, I'm taking that off myself, and he misses the shot.
Good steal, good steal. That's what Central needs.
Turnover.
All day.
Changer Burch off the glass.
Let's check out this replay. Nice up and under left hand scoop by Preston Cunningham. Emery for his second three.
Durant with a three-pointer. Back up to a seven-point lead for the Trainers. Yeah, Durant's hitting the shots early in this game. Usually he takes a little while to warm up, but hey, don't let him get too hot.
No, don't let him.
13-8.
Good move right there with the left.
Durant with a little dipsy do and a scoop. Durant with 8 points already. 15-8 ball game. Mechanic Arts up by seven.
And he shot that with the left. Mismatch.
Cunningham with another little easy
Cunningham
bucket.
With six big points.
Putting that back here. Birch with the shot.
Dwayne Johnson.
Back to live action. Dwayne Johnson with the quick two points. Timeout in the game.
Uh-oh. Right now they have a little bit of going on with Central bench. They're not respecting the coach.
7 point game here. 17-10, Mechanic Arts is up.
And look at here.
Mechanic Arts brought in four fresh players. We got Bibbins, Williams.
Keller,
right? Another law firm. What is with this?
Shoot. Emery with 8 points. Dwayne Johnson with 7 points.
Well, they got 15 of the first 17 points.
Now, this should be an interesting matchup right here. I like this one. The youth movement.
Well, we got Poole.
I see Cunningham staying on the blocks. Too small.
And Cameron Smith in.
Too small.
Oh, Cunningham with a nice shot, but it rolled off the rim.
I like this matchup.
Durant with the pass to Bibbins. He'll take the three.
Pointers.
A little pushing underneath the basket there, but no foul call. Oh, he fired it up hard.
Take out the game, who ignited himself.
Bibbins, a nice little.
He has a good game. I like Bibbins' game.
It was an outlet pass by Bibbins to Durant. Nice pass by Emery over to Keller.
Good fast break.
Track meet out there, 21-10, 11-point lead.
That was a good way to run the floor.
Pull to Johnson. Johnson pull it up. Foul on the play.
Let's look at that replay there. Good move right there, good move. Good footwork.
He kept the ball away from the defender and just up and up.
You know, I'll give Bibbins credit. I always see him in the gym and he's working on his footwork. One day he might make it to the league. Or the league might make it to him.
Okay. Johnson, free throw shot, he puts it in. Back to a 10-point game. 18 minutes left in the first half. Mechanic Arts 21-11. And he misses the second one. All right. Emory kicks it back out to Williams.
Oh, throw away.
Cross court pass.
Wrong person.
That goes away.
One bucket at a time. Wrong person. All right, Central, y'all got to do something.
Well, nothing hurt on that. You know, he's looking for an open man. He was open. He's overthrew it. Poole takes it up by himself and comes up short, but they get the rebound. Cameron Smith with the long three. Bivens.
Rebound, Bivens.
No one's
rebound.
Taking that from him.
One man fast break. Oh.
Durant passes it off. Keller. Pull with the rebound. Oh, he missed. Cameron was streaking up the other side of the court.
Good get back. Good get back.
Nice. Good play. Good play. Good give and go. 21-13. Mechanic Irons over Central.
You know who should be in this game right now for Central?
Ronnie?
Changa.
Yeah, that was.
This is a Changa pace.
Yeah, it is. Nice little give and go back.
Very nice scoop shot.
Emory Durant with the long three. Preston, rebound. Butler being pressured. Back to Poole. Pull behind the back. And Poole comes up short.
He's pulling.
All day.
Keller. One of the Keller brothers.
It's up to 11-point lead.
He gets the hit, he'll shoot. He ain't afraid to shoot.
Cameron Smith.
Good pass. Preston.
Smith to Cunningham. An easy bucket off the glass. Back to a single-digit lead. Well, I'm sorry. It's a 9-point lead.
That's single.
Williams.
Deep.
Here comes Central.
Who puts that ball up? This is what Central needs. Now you got to cut with him. No movement.
Yep. Got to get rid
of
it.
He'll shoot.
Coming up short. Got to follow. Williams. Takes it all the way. Comes up short. Got numbers for Central. And Poole capitalized. Good play from Smith to Poole. 24-17, 15-06 left in the half. Kelly.
Told you he'll pull. Good hustle. Good hustle.
Poole.
Oh.
Comes up short. A little too hard. Can Mechanic Arts cash in on that? Yes.
Keller brothers.
Keller, Keller. Keller, Keller, Durant.
Andre and Vernon.
It's a quick-paced game. 10-point lead.
Yes, it is. This is what we asked for now. A little more excitement. Let's see that 3-point shot.
All day.
Nice corner shot by DeAndre Keller.
All right, little dissension over there on the red team.
Too many players in the game right now.
It's not hockey. You got one body too many over there. You got two players too many.
See, now this is what hurts.
They had six on the court, one was inbounding over here. All right, we're going with McNeil, Smith, Bronaugh, Birch, and Walker for the Minutemen in Johnson, Hicks, Griffin, Chapman, and one of the Kellers.
McNeil to Bronaugh.
Bronaugh comes up short. You give him an assist on that?
Yes. Okay. Good pass. Good pass.
Chang with the good rebound. Pass. He puts it back up for two.
I remember Bronaugh back in the day. He knocked them shots down.
Don't leave Keller alone.
Why? Give me a reason.
Well, Jesse, don't leave him alone. Ronnie Smith. Nice pass by McNeil. Ronnie comes up short. Come on, old school. Use that glass when you're inside like that.
Oh,
way to go, Changa. Good hustle by Changa. Works.
All over.
No, take it to the hole. Take it to the hole, Changa. And.
Yeah, he should have attacked the rim on that one.
He stopped to see if he was all right.
Wade Johnson, who said he's feeling it a little bit.
The Rock.
The Rock.
It's back up to a 10-point lead again, 29-19 with 13, a little over 13 left in the half. Neil looking for an opening.
Oh, no. Good cutoff. Good defense there.
Earl's not getting any height on them shots.
No.
He's line driving them. Take your time. You got a lot of time. No one's pressuring you. Hicks. Backs in McNeil, and he comes up. He's fouled.
He shuffles the feet and looks and going.
Oh, he goes. Oh, I thought it was a foul.
Oh, it was a shuffle of the feet.
Oh, I missed that.
All right.
Changa Birch off the glass.
Okay, we got some confusion going on here.
Not really.
We got too many men out there again.
So you know when these games is meaning something here, where the competition has risen, has gone up.
Let's see. Tee him up over there. Let's see.
But love is always in the air. What we got going on here?
All right, let's get back to the action here.
I gotta say, somebody please explain something to us.
All right.
Here we go.
McNeil brings it up for Central.
Too small.
Cunningham, he's being pressured. Whoa.
Uh-oh.
Blue ball.
On the ref.
Well, Durant's back out there for him. And Chapman again.
He'll shoot.
He had Griffin open up on the other side of the key. Cunningham.
Boston with 10 big points in the first half.
8-point lead. They cut it to 8, 29-21. Mechanic Arts. Durant looking for a man, but decides to take the shot himself, and he misfires.
Attack. Oh, yeah. That's called an unforced error there.
That was, because he had it.
Yes, he did.
You know, miscommunication. He fell asleep because he could have laid that one up.
Allen Hicks, what's he going to do? Oh, he's ready to pull that one.
We're at a disadvantage here. It's 5-on-4 down here.
Wow.
Brokaw hasn't came back up the court. He's open now by Emory Durant.
It's the three.
Big three.
Hold up, I was like, hey, hold up, man. I'm chilling.
This track meet has turned into a walk race now. Changa with the three. Back to an 8-point lead. You see, Central just can't seem to get, you know, any kind of stops when they score.
Good D right there. Oh,
On the three.
Man, that was a foul. Come on, fellas.
Just over the past few years, I would have let him shoot that.
Yeah, you see what happened. Yeah. The results were.
Yeah, okay.
Can Allen capitalize on this?
Oh, is this a one-legger?
Let's see. Class of 76.
I'm going to hit all three of these, he said. Did he say I'm going to miss all three of these because he don't drink water?
It's only one. Oh, my goodness.
More substitutions, and they're leaving the Young Bucks on the bench.
Let's go, man. Let's go. We got three shots. Taking our time.
Oh, that's two waters. Ooh, Allen. Oh, he missed again. I have faith in him on this one, too.
You do? I have no faith.
Well, I guess that was a good foul.
What? Why isn't the Young Bucks in the game?
They get the break on the three missed free throws, then they turn the ball over. I don't know. Maybe this bad luck is carrying over to this game. Durant with the ball. He got Bivens back in the game with Hicks. Bivens comes up a little short. Poole with the rebound. Matt Birch with the hustle.
Keel with the hustle.
Nice save by the coach.
Body. There you go. There we go.
And it's down to a 6-point game with 8:12 left in the first half. D. Johnson to rock. We got a hacking foul on the arm. I don't know if it was on Poole or was it on Keel.
You need a sub.
Wayne Johnson passes up to Bivens. Good pass.
Oh, that's a one-man fast break there.
Birch misses the easy layup.
Hicks, can he make him pay? Nope.
He could have made it a 4-point game, but you can see he's coming up. Poole. Kick goal, get
and one.
That might be the break they needed.
And one.
He's a shot again.
Yeah, Ronnie good Smith. Shot by Ronnie.
Square it up and put
just,
it down.
I just want to know. I just want to know the substitution that they're doing.
And with Central. Which one, Central?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's more like a revolving door. Poole, can he cash in on the foul?
3-point play, the traditional way.
It's a 3-point lead. 32-29, Mechanic Arts. It's letting Central chip its way back in this game.
Johnson
silences them with that with the big three. He's back up to 6 points.
The bank is open on a Saturday.
Yep. Poole. Catches everybody sleeping. He takes it straight to the right.
Yes, he does.
Or easy to. A lot of heavy breathing going out there, Tim.
Yes, it is. Time to make a sub.
That kind of defense is not going to work on Emory. Bivens hits the roll.
I think Bivens got some pearls around his neck. Or it might be them little candy necklaces.
Throw to Birch.
That could be all day.
And Birch comes up short. Central needs some rebounding. Durant to Bivens. Another one, but he misses the layup. But he's going to the line.
And I just see it over there that Centro and Mechanic Arts coaches are having a conversation.
Maybe we're going to make a trade at halftime.
Probably. Probably tell Akil if you stay in the game. This is
Courtney Bivens, Island Park class 2000. He'll hit that in his sleep. I know one thing, they better give Cunningham a breather.
I want to know about Central substitution going on right now. Three of the young guys that have been sitting on the bench for quite a while.
Got a foul down here.
Pushing and shoving going on.
Not a lot of fouls have been called in this game. Don't there be any bonus shooting in this half.
If you look at it, there's no fouls being called.
7-point lead, 38-31. Mechanic Arts lead Central.
Good defense. Good defense.
Great defense there by Bivens.
Good defense back.
Oh. They still keep the ball.
Shoot that.
And Durant.
And hit. Hit.
I swear. He's picking up from what? From last year.
Yeah.
Back to a 10-point advantage for the Trainers. Pressed by Williams. Whoa. Now he just bustled his way on that one.
Left hand scoop again. And deep ball.
Pulled the rebound. Got nothing. Nope. You know, Central has a chance of running out there, but every time they get a rebound, they don't look up. Well, Bivens stops that. 43-33, back to a 10-point advantage. Double teaming on Mechanics, and it's working. Forces Central into bad shots.
I'm just trying to figure this game out. The flow is just a little erratic for me right now, but Emory is just pulling and pulling and pulling.
Whoa.
Four 3-pointers.
46-33. A 3-point advantage turns into a 13-point advantage.
I mean, we got some good scoring going on this first half, too. I'm loving it.
This is like,
I'm loving this score in the first
half. Durant is just like, he's killing them.
Durant?
Yes.
Johnson?
Bivens?
Bivens? Them three.
And they're just all around our hustling Central.
Yes, they are. And to me, right now, I'm looking at it, Central don't have a flow. You know, their substitution flow isn't what it should be right now. And that's why they're down 13 points.
Yeah, I thought they were going to make a, you know, at least tie it up. They cut it to three, but, you know.
Let's look at this three-pointer by
13-0 run. Durant.
His fourth of the game so far.
All right, back to live action with 2:34 left in the first half. Central's ball. Got McNeil and Poole bringing it up. We got Birch. Cunningham and Johnson for Central on the court.
Oh, the rebound.
Good hustle by Johnson.
Uh-huh.
Coming up short, though. Hicks with the rebound off to Williams. Williams getting pressured by McNeil. Not for long.
They're screaming for a travel, but they're saying McNeil gave him the body. But he was trying to hit the corner.
I'd have to see that from another angle. Looked like he just fell down.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Bivens. And he missed. But the Trainers. Pull with the rebound.
Poole's been controlling the ball. Changa. Oh. Attack that rim.
But they just never by a basket. Good hustle, but nothing's falling.
Yeah.
46-33 with 1:24 left in the half.
Hicks.
Hicks coming up short.
Good pass. Get it out of here.
Williams with the loose ball.
Nice try. What's the ball, Central?
Bippin's been holding on to the pass. No foul.
Oh, nice try, nice try. Bippin's bringing the ball up. You don't want to get a ball to Hicks. Johnson, who's been hot early.
Johnson, go with another three.
Hot.
It's raining threes for the trainers this
hot.
Afternoon. 48-33. As the clock winds down for the first half.
Between Durant and Johnson, they have 7 3-pointers.
Ouch. Poole turns it over.
Oh.
Man. Oh. Hey, be careful, fellas.
Clock. Largest lead of the game so far, 15, with 22.5 to go in the first half.
48-33.
Man. Let's check out the replay here.
Johnson
in the
Johnson. And finds the bottom of the net. All right, Williams will be shooting two. Will he add to the lead or not?
So what you think, Bernard, second half?
Oh. Well, if this keeps up, they're going to run him out of the gym.
Running him out of the gym.
So she's got to make some adjustments.
This is not what we anticipated.
17-point lead at the half.
17-point lead.
50-33. Wow, yeah, they kept up the track beat, and they just ran Central out of here, man.
They took off and didn't stop. And at one point, you thought Central was going to come back in and make a run. And when they thought the run was coming, here came the sub.
Well, I think that's the problem. The substitution over there is not working. I don't think people are following instructions over there.
Well, and it's not the way it should be. And that's what's causing a mass confusion with Central right now. And that's why they're down 17 points. Get it together, brothers. Get it together. There's still hope and a light at the end of the tunnel.
All right. This time I'd like to take time out.
Yes.
To give a special thanks to our sponsors. So we would start with Central High School and the Mechanic Arts M Club, the EAB Distribution Incorporated, Ellis Enterprise Incorporated, West Indy Soul Community Stabilization Project, Faith Community Action, Twin Cities Radio Network, SPPN, Rondo Avenue Incorporated, Frogtown Neighborhood Association, Hallie Q. Brown Community Center, and the Jimmy Lee Recreation Center. Also St. Paul Almanac, Aurora St. Anthony Neighborhood Club, the RS Executive Protection Incorporation, High School for the Recording Arts, HSRA, Truth Preparatory Academy, Advanced Design Contracting Roofing and Sheet Metal, Run Tell That Barbecue, Golden Time Coffee Cafe, Sweet Inspirations, Booker Construction, Heart to Heart Transportation, Selby Wine and Spirits, and
Big Daddy's Barbecue, African American Comforts, Brooks Funeral Home, Fabulous Ferns, Sheer Pleasure Salon of Beauty, The Best Steakhouse, Heart to Heart, Bouquet by Carolyn, Assurance Depot, Butterfly for Life, DJ Mickey Breeze Incorporated, Pizza Lucci, Going Places Floral Virtuoso, Sugar Rush, Hickory Hut, Macklemore Construction, CBV, Greg Buster, Pilgrim Baptist Church. Thank you all for all your support, and please, please keep it up for our 25th annual Mechanic Arts Central Alumni Basketball Game. We are at halftime right now, folks, and we will talk to you in probably about a few more minutes. All right, enjoy the festivities.
We just want one moment just to acknowledge Mr. Brazelton. Now, I probably can talk for hours or so about Mike. We all grew up together. Okay?
All right.
You know, when you are. I know we all get old, we're gonna pass away. And one of the things about this event that we do for you. So often, we always look for others to start stuff for us, and we don't wanna do that. Me might go back, when I first came up here from Mississippi, Mike, Brazelton, Roger Harris, probably the two guys that I left on to, having older brothers, helped me to get used to this Minnesota Nice, if we want to call that. But we know that's a lie. We know that's a lie. But with that said, I mean, they helped me settle in. Took me through some tough times, what I was dealing with as a teenager, dealing with school. But their older brothers taught me how to play the game of basketball. They did it right. So they made three of us play them. Larry Brazelton and Michael Harris. They made myself, Roger Harris, and Mike Brazelton played them every day until we were able to beat them. So they taught us a lesson. So right now what I see, I know we all have things that we want to share with folks, but sometimes we have to start taking life a little serious at age. And what I'm saying right now, sometimes it's not happening. I see most of us sometimes we'll go past each other, don't even acknowledge that we are the same. All right? So this was tough for me today, we're not able to go and see him say goodbye to him. Still tough. Now, I don't know if you guys realize, it was hard to even get this place. The last couple years, we've been having someone to try to sabotage the game itself. It's been tough. So it's not about the ball players. It's not about you. It's about the future. What are we gonna do for ourselves? So this is what I ask, all we ask. Let's try to be a little more kind to each other, to understand each other, and not so quickly want to fight or shoot or whatever, or talk about each other. Those days should be over now. Only people can hurt us is us ourselves. And if we're not teaching the young ones to be more up with each other, then we're wrong. Next thing, when is it gonna stop? When is it gonna stop? The few of us here right now, and we can start to add in some love with each other, whether they're family or not, we'll be better off. Trust me. And it's hard, but it shouldn't be hard. So we need to make this game get even bigger. Love each other a little more than we have been in the past. Teach the little ones. Let's not teach them to start a cursing. But most times we have to deal with it. So if you don't do anything else today, let's take some of this home and think about it. How can we connect with each other like we used to do it? We used to do this. I know we talk about the other cultures, what they do, what they got, what they have. They haven't had no more than what we had. Listen to what I'm saying. What? So let's get back to what we normally do. Let's love each other, for each other, and be real. On that note, I'm gonna say you guys have fun, and let's pull ourselves together. You know we're having educational problems. Let's find a way how we can work with organizations that really want to make a difference. The biggest part of showing up. When we know we got to start talking to someone and getting something done, let's show up at one, not just one person. I want to thank the committee for sticking in there with me. Give yourself a hand, please. But we need to add more help. So get in touch with some of us. You really want to help, get in touch with them. We'd be glad to have you. All right, thanks, have fun.
That's a missing thought. That was wonderful thing what Henry just pointed out to us, you know. And that's what's missing back in our community, where it is the love. It is them villages.
That's, you know, true. That's true.
It is.
There's, I mean, there's a big gap from
a large
like I'd
gap.
Say our generation to that next
yeah.
generation.
You know, our kids is running around wild a little bit, and we need to start getting the grasp up on them. You know, teach them some ways, you know. We and have to.
And another thing he touched on, like Mike Brazelton, who was going to play in this year's game, you know, he passed away last week, unfortunately, yeah. for those who don't know. And, you know, he was a cool dude. You know, I liked him a lot, and everybody liked him. And, you know, it was really a shock. News came around that he had passed away. But he was all pumped up to play this year. He would have played sparingly minutes, like he said, but he right. was going to go out there and give it his all. But his spirit lives on, and, you know, his team is putting the pumping on Sutra today. So,
yeah.
Hey, this for you, Mike.
Send the condolences out to
say
your
that
family.
For your teammates. Yeah. You guys are taking it to us this year.
Hey, game ain't won in the first well, half.
No, so. It's not. It's okay. not. It's not. It's
if
not.
Games are won in the first half, yeah. there'll be a lot that, of
that's
championship
That's true. That's
teams,
true.
You know. So, hey, Central, get it together. Back to action.
So we're about to start. We got Keller, Williams. Keller, Johnson, and Bibbins for the trainers. And we got Poole, Cunningham, Smith, Johnson, and we got a new guy out there. Who's this? Butler. Butler's out there.
Butler is out there.
For the Minutemen.
Yes,
let's play ball,
oh,
fellas.
Oh.
Johnson the rebound.
Johnson starts off
back
like
up.
He started off the first half. Scoring.
52-33. Start the second half.
Oh,
Taylor Garrett drew blood first. Ball's tip. Back to Mechanics.
Mechanics, largest lead of the game.
Lost the handle on, and he ended up losing the handle. They pass it up. kind of easy too for Smith.
We need a lot more of them.
They need stops.
We need a lot more of them.
They need stops. They're keeping that ball moving though.
Looking for a call on that one, but I don't think they gave it to him. Turnover.
You know, Fisher was out. He wasn't in position to make that call.
Are they ever? No, I'm just kidding. Just kidding. JK. Smith deep.
And he comes up.
Tight rim.
Misfire.
Cunningham, who's been a force.
Cunningham, he's a leading scorer for Central.
One of their lone bright spots.
52-37, the lead's cut down to 15.
D. Keller. He'll pull. What'd I tell you?
Keller misfires. Butler rebound.
Come on, push it up.
Find the open man.
Swing that ball. Too small. Too small.
With the old high school move.
I like the little English he put on there.
Yeah, nice play.
Keller. Tap. He made up his mind on that one.
I took it all the way to the window and deposited. Cool. Almost lost it. They're not moving on Central's team.
Good block. Good rebound.
Butler, good hustle.
For three.
They're slowly chipping away at this lead. 54-42.
They got to do it on this end, though, right here. Defense.
Whoa. Keller with a nice shot, but it wouldn't fall. Good pass, Butler, and the rebound. Poole with another one. Down to a 10-point lead.
This is what Central needed, a little run. I'll keep it up.
Need a couple more stops, though.
We need them.
There's a stop.
Good pass.
Good play. That was
good.
I'd like to see that again.
Yes. That was nice.
Nice look. Nice look, Smith.
Oh, good dribble, Bivens. And that's his shot right there. And he's missing. Mechanic Eisner went cold.
I'm surprised they didn't call the timeout. Smith beyond the Keller boys.
Oh,
that was
wrong player.
Wrong player, that's true. Good defense by the Kellers. They forced him to throw that one away.
Okay, now they might got, they got Emery coming back in. Dwayne Johnson, the Rock.
They couldn't, it was an 18-point lead, now it's down to 8. And we've only burned less than 5 minutes off the clock.
Yeah. Keller, look at Jenkins everywhere. He shoot, Wide open out there. Kanga is his old self of always causing a disruption in the game.
That's
always causing a disruption in the game. That's why I love his game. We'll call him the disruptor. Oh,
Can
no.
Central
come on.
Central doesn't need this at this point in the game. Two times they could cut it to a 6-point lead, and they turn the ball over on both occasions.
Certain aspects of the game, I like it when you just get that pass up. You don't have to dribble to wait.
No.
He was open. Feed open man, you're liable to get it back. Bivens, the shot. He ain't made it.
Yeah.
that ball. Senga, and it's at six.
6 point advantage now.
Central.
Can he get another stop here?
He's on a 10-0 run, Central is on.
But Bibbins misses an easy turnaround.
He missed his last three shots. And he pulls up for three. Oh, Central.
And it's a...
He's on a 13-0 run.
3 point game. The Minutemen have came right back into this one. They got new life with 18:23 left in the second half. Central has cut it to a 3 point advantage.
Just when we was almost calling them out.
We're just putting the dirt on them. They just,
we was.
You know, they rose from the ashes.
Yes, let's look at this replay again. Good three.
On the bottom of the net.
Who finally hits a 3 point?
A lot of
big three.
Things that they did in the last 5 minutes was playing defense.
Yes.
And it didn't help Mechanics' case, they were missing shots either.
True.
But you know that. All right, give it.
What we got there?
All right, back in 1984, the Boston Celtics, I hated the Celtics, beat the LA Lakers 4-3 in that year's NBA Finals. That year's draft class included Hakeem Olajuwon, Michael Jordan, and Charles Barkley.
Central Missouri State men's and women's basketball win NCAA Division II titles, becoming the first school in any division to earn a sweep.
And back in 84, Prince released Purple Rain, featuring Let's Go Crazy, and When Doves Cry.
Oh.
Back to live action, Central gets a force to turnover.
Oh.
And it's a 1 point advantage.
15-0 run.
Yeah, they got a little pep in their step now.
Now the young guys is out there. Oh.
Keller misses. Nice try by Cunningham.
Come on, Emory, get it done. Get it under your feet, Emory. Bivens. Oh, good defense. Good defense.
It's a jump off. No jump off.
Good defense. Jump ball.
This possession here favors Central. Great defense by Preston Cunningham. He just tied him up. Cameron Smith being pressured.
Central wants to take the lead. Good move, Chenga. And Central.
Central has come back and take their first lead of the game.
A 17-0 run.
55-54. Keller turns it over. Touchdown. Emory Durant. Interception.
He's shooting. Okay.
All right, Keller.
There he goes.
Keller found his eye back. He got his eye back. 57-55. Mechanic Arts up by two.
Bomb down.
Well, he should have passed that off. He just tried to do too much with that. Look at the Keller boys.
There he is.
Keller. Ooh, back to a 4 point advantage. 59-55.
On a 17-0 run.
Doing too much. Come on, you got to pass that ball around. You got four other guys on the team with you.
Good call, ref. Okay. Have you noticed something with Central now? You're back in the game.
Yeah.
Now you're playing individual. Come on, that ain't what got you that 17-1 to put you back in the game. Move that ball around. He came down after taking the lead.
59-55 with 15:49 left in the game. The Mechanic Arts. Johnson to Durant, but it's intercepted by Smith.
That
good defense by Emory Durant.
Don't hesitate.
Yeah, he thought about shooting it first, probably.
Did Keller
hit him again? With a hurt now? Bibbins comes up.
He's going to shoot.
The rebound. Oh. That looked clean.
Ooh, on the ref. That's a bailout foul.
Oh.
Yeah. That's a bailout call.
I don't know about that one.
Oh, Bivens.
That was not a good one.
Bivens has been gone up out of here. So that's one of just sitting here going, you know, what's he going to do about that?
Wow. Well, can he capitalize on this?
Okay.
He got the one. Back to a 5-point game.
All right, Central needs a bucket here now. You can't make this comeback and then lose control. Swiftness, good pass.
Come on now. Let's...
Not good. This right here is where you call it. You need a timeout.
Right. Well, you know, when you want Central to pass, they don't. And then when they do pass, they make one too many passes. You got to know when to pull the trigger. All right, it's back to a 5-point game. I think Mechanic Arts has settled in. You know, that cold spell is over for them.
Yeah.
You got Williams bringing up, no pressure yet. Central in the 2-1-2 zone. Was that 2-3?
Looks like a 2-3. What they did, what Mechanic Arts did, they got the high low now. Big man at the high.
Williams is coming up short. Jenga.
Bully. Oh, come on.
He missed. You got to use the glass. They can't buy a basket.
Oh, my goodness. There they go.
And only took four attempts, but they got 3 points out of it. 2-point game, 60-58. And here comes Kudobin.
Give the ball. Uh-oh, he fills it.
He fills it. Whoa, spit.
He fills it.
Cameron, victory. He's on fire. So he's got the lead back, 61-60.
Chair. He's had on it. All right, Central, come on.
Back to a 1-point game. Can't go.
It's hot.
Honey, that was hot. Smith comes up short on that attempt.
Rumbling and stumbling.
Posterized.
That's why they say don't reach, or I'll
teach.
That's right. Oh, good luck.
Almost lost it. Coming up short.
They got to have better possession. They're getting tired. Get some subs in now.
Take a better shot, too. 1-point advantage for Mechanic Arts.
Oh,
Johnson misses an easy layup. Going back and forth like, who wants this?
Timeout call by Central.
Here's a little tip. Back out. Chanka Birch. Another tip. Smith says, oh, let me have it. I'll knock out a three.
Yeah, he got hot. Our future stars is out there warming up.
Bet you hits it. Oh, no, he missed. Yeah.
Alumniers right out here on the court.
Starting on right. Yes. No. Follow through on that one, young man. All right, what do you think Jerry's telling him over here in the huddle?
You know what?
Slow
just
down.
Telling them, fellas, calm down, y'all. Okay? Relax. This is our game to lose. Relax.
Now, Central doesn't say anything.
Central, I don't know. Just sub right.
and play.
Okay. McNeil's back in. Poole's in there. Cunningham, Birch, and Butler.
Okay, that's a good, that's good footprint in there.
They give Cameron a, break. Poole's bringing it up back to live action.
Hopefully Poole got in there, got a little rest, and see what he needs to do. That's
right. Just over 11 minutes left in the half.
Good move, Chega. Oh.
Just can't finish it. Still a one-point advantage for the Trainers. Williams being pressured by Poole.
They in a zone.
Keller, back to Hicks.
Oh.
You got 3 seconds.
Traveling, whatever you want to call. Take your pick.
I thought he's done an order of pizza while he's in this. Still a one-point lead for Mechanic. 62-61.
Control back on the rhythm. Got a rhythm?
Nope.
Nope.
A lot of individual play down here for some. Yeah. They should be passing that ball around.
Yeah, thank you for not on that one. Because I sure was just thinking.
Hicks kicks it up the corner.
He'll shoot. What'd I tell you?
And he missed by. We're at their point where everyone's hitting the wall.
Man, they're just pulling. It's one-on-one. So play four corners and open it up.
Whoa, nice block.
Good defense. Get him on the arm, though. Got him on the arm.
Oh, okay. But he came out of nowhere and got a piece of that. And him.
Is it shooting or is it on the pass? We're giving it 2 shots.
We'll see. Yep. Burt, first one.
Ah.
Well, they're at a disadvantage now.
My thing is, go ahead and run up and down and sub.
Put on the track shoes. Tie game, 62-62 with 8:53 left.
Oh!
And Williams.
Williams finally got him in.
Drops the three from the left side. Poole being pressured by Williams.
One-on-one. So not going to win this game. I've been seeing 2 to 3 passes and a shot. It is. They're listening to us.
You know what? They shouldn't even came to that point. The guy should have been in the game.
Well, the fans might agree on that.
Just under 8 minutes. 3 points, 65-62 lead. Wow. Mechanics. Williams with another three. Keller with the big rebound. Good putback.
Yes, it was.
5-point advantage. 67-62. Central. Oh, that'll work. If you can't score that way, you get up free throws.
Can he knock down the free throws, though?
Now I'm wondering what Central's going to do now as far as. Gotta have those. Got to have those.
Shooting a little softer. They're free. They are free.
Oh, I thought that was going to pop out too.
I thought that was a pop type.
It looked like it. There's a big turnover. We got numbers.
Oh.
when they needed it. Can they add to the lead? Yes. Up to a 6-point advantage, 69-63. Just over 6 minutes left in the game. That could be frustrating. Wasting an opportunity like that with a 3-on-1 advantage and you get nothing out of it.
Who's that old school? I'm a fake at you. You threw him off.
Then you turn it over in the process.
Yeah. That was a 4-point turnaround right there.
Yep. You got Bibbins back in, so they got more rebounding and shooting.
They're saying too small.
No one's coming in to rebound. Everyone's standing around the perimeter.
Look around besides Cunningham. Where are the rebounds?
He's going to block.
Oh, in and out.
It's a good shot, but it just wouldn't fall in.
He'll shoot.
He's been pretty quiet this half. Well, the whole team from Mechanic Arts has been, but Emory, he's, I don't think he's hit
very
a shot
quiet
yet, has he?
Nope.
Smith, the impression. McNeil.
Cool.
He got it.
They need it.
Back to a 3-point advantage, 69-66. Standard 5 minutes to play.
That was needed.
Can the Minutemen get a stop here?
Henry pulls up.
Count it, count it.
Playing big now. His shot on the three is out, so he know what he should do. Start bringing that ball in. Sometimes that's what worries me about that 3-point line.
Yeah, but he had rebounders done.
Yes.
You know, if he doesn't make it, Keller and Keller were there, so was Bibbins. Now they're going to add to the man.
Another
back to the and one.
The board. They have an advantage on the board.
They're killing them on the board.
But there's really not too much that you can do about it. Get Sam in the game, that'll help out a little more. Traditional 3-point play by Vernon Keller.
74-66 up to an 8-point advantage. And it's not looking good for the home team right here. Poole. And another one-on-one basketball with Central.
This could be a dagger.
Actually, Bibbins should have let that ball go because it was for Keller. Keller could have caught it 1-2 and laid it up off the glass.
And that's communicated to him.
Yeah, he should have put his hands down because Keller was coming right up, up the lane there. Bibbins, yes. You see he's making the free throws now.
Well, I gotta say the fat lady's in the locker room.
The boys in the blue.
Warming up.
Pool checks out.
There's timeout on the floor.
Oh, okay.
All right. Look at the benches. Look at Mechanic Arts. Look at Central. That's the difference in the game right now.
Yeah, it is. You didn't buy a ticket, did you, Tim?
I didn't know nothing about
it. Oh. You won $1,500.
Huh?
7028. 7028.
Somebody won. Oh, okay.
Shooting one.
All right. So where are we at here? We got 3:01 left in the game. Mechanics shoot free throws, and they're making them now.
Oh,
no, he's making it. He ain't missing no more from the free throw line, okay?
10-point game.
He was off in the first half. But they got it. All right.
1-on-1.
We got the roll that time. 76-68, 8-point advantage.
They need rebounds and defense. Defensive rebound. All Mechanics got to do is move the ball around. Look at the hustle, see?
Point game, 76-72. All Mechanics Arts has to do is just pass the ball around. And the game's in the bag.
Jump up.
Why don't they foul? It stops the clock. Well, he stopped it there, but.
Yeah, that was big seconds there.
Who's that big lady over there by the door? Warming up. Bivens. Now they foul. This is crazy. I thought we were getting ready to sing.
It's a 4-point game.
This is crazy.
109.
They should have fouled. They should have stopped. He should have called and stopped the clock.
That's Coach it.
Then they should have fouled. Now they do. 50 seconds later.
See, we have to be managers of the game.
Because no one was in the bonus.
No one was in the bonus.
76-72 with 105 left in the game. 65 seconds. And it don't look good for Central. Well, they've been hoping they're cold at the line now. Bivens was the first one, and he capitalized. I hear that door creaking. It's starting to close.
Yes, it is.
Can he add to it?
Oh,
no.
This is big right here.
Big.
That was big right there. That was
they needed their rebound.
They needed that shot. That shot right there.
I don't know why he went to the basket with that. He should have passed it to Johnson.
Well,
he could have ran some more time off the clock. He could have dribbled it out here and been done with it.
That's true, but he's going through the free throw line, so hopefully
he can.
So we'll see after that. See how that one plays out.
We're still not in the bonus yet.
Oh.
Oh, they're falling down now.
Yes, they are. The coach is going up in the stands. Well.
And he hits two of them.
It's caught. Turn out the lights. The party's over.
79-72.
Mechanic Arts wins two in a row. Oh, would you say there's a chance?
Pass it to someone to shoot the three. Oh, wow, look at that.
Oh.
It is.
It is. Mechanic Arts take this one.
This one's in the book.
Back to back win. They take the series lead 13-12. Mad substitutions come in now. I don't see no Carters in the game.
It's a comfortable 7-point lead at this time, too. With 18 seconds left in the game. And
we have some foul outs.
Is he all right over there?
He took a heavy hit. Gonna shoot. Allie gonna shoot.
Oh, but I'd
say he was ready. He was ready.
He was gonna let. He was locked and loaded.
Well, folks.
Well, Allen can just
pat his stats. 11.6 to go in the game, up by 7. Can he make one?
Oh. Well, best case scenario, Citro hits 2 3-pointers and gets fouled on
him. Within 9 seconds?
I've seen crazier things happen. Well, that's not one of them. Counting down, and that's the ball game, folks. 79-72, Mechanic Arts broken the stalemate at 12 apiece for convincing in the last 2 minutes. 79-72 victory today at St. Paul Central.
I'll give Central credit for making that run and putting themselves back in the game.
Yeah, they did.
That was a great run. 17-0 run, that was great.
Yeah, they were down 18, and they came back, and then they took the lead briefly.
Yep, yep. A couple times.
It was going back and forth, but.
And you know what, too, though? The other thing on that is what helped Central is what hurt Central. Central, when they came back and did that run in, then they started playing individual ball. They quit going from the team concept.
They did a lot of that.
That hurts us. That hurts us as basketball players, whereas we forget what got us in the game, and we go away from the game. Lesson learned, young ones. Lesson learned.
A lot of one-on-one. One-on-one, and they're done. They add it all up.
Hey, man, but now, you know what? I appreciate always working with you, man.
Hey, Tim, it's always a pleasure. It's always a pleasure to see you, to work with you.
Yes.
And ladies and gentlemen, one more time, that was the end of the 25th annual Central Alumni, Mechanic Arts Alumni game. I tip my hat to the victors, Mechanic Arts, convincing 79-72 win. And on that tip, Tim, it's a pleasure. I'll see you next year, and we're signing off.
Signing off, y'all. Have a great one and enjoy.
Goodbye.
Peace.